While back to school can be an exciting time for students ready to return to their favorite teachers and friends, it can also be a really stressful time when, unfortunately, the bullies and even cyber bullies make a return. Here to help and shed some light on this very important topic is John Reese. He's a retired lieutenant for the Providence Police Department and founder of PAVE. Thanks so much for being here.
No problem.
Let's start there. What is PAVE?
Partnership to Address Violence Through Education. It's a nonprofit I formed about 7-8 years ago to deal predominantly with bullying prevention and education.
And I'm sure with your background, you did see obviously a lot of, you know, forms of violence, whether they were like really heavy or even, you know, we mentioned violence in the classrooms, and sometimes it's just like verbal, and that comes from bullying.
Yeah, absolutely, and that's perceptive of you to realize it. It's, you know, whether it's domestic violence, gang violence, you know, some of the youth violence we're seeing in cities, it's all a form of bullying. It's about power and control.
Yeah.
It's about sometimes feeling good about yourself when you don't, which is the problem with schoolyard bullying. For lack of a better term, because young people that are being bullied will then in turn bully someone else to kind of get some of that power back that they've lost.
Yeah, you want to feel better about yourself by putting someone else down.
Absolutely.
And unfortunately, now it's happening on multiple platforms.
Yes, yeah. Technology has not done us any favors when it comes to bullying. And you know, one thing I have to stress with parents is we have to realize that now young people, you know, some as young as 8-9 years old that are giving any type of device that can access the internet,
yeah,
that they can go anywhere in the universe at any time, talk to anyone about anything.
It's scary.
It's incredible. Yeah.
So how are parents out there going to identify when maybe their child is being bullied? Are there signs to look for?
Yeah, there are, especially in school children. A lot of times kids don't want to go to school. And it sounds pretty simple, but you know, they'll come up with these mysterious stomach aches and little aches and pains. And they don't usually share a lot with parents because they're afraid parents are going to come in, make a big deal out of it, and the bullying is going to get worse.
Yeah.
You know, one of the things I do with students at my school is I tell them, look, if you come in and let me know what's happening, I promise you, I'm not going to do anything until we work out an agreement on how to do it so the kid feels control.
Yeah.
Because again, that's what that kid's looking for, is control. So if I just become the only person handling it, they're still out of control.
So that's one of the ways, I mean, for them to approach you, maybe kind of like an outside individual. But what are some other ways that you can combat bullying?
I think from a parental standpoint, you got to talk to your children. We really got to get back to teaching old-fashioned values. I hate to, you know, give my age, but, you know, kids today, we're such a self-generated culture now, young people are.
Yeah.
You know, just the word selfie. So it's all about who I am and about how I feel and what I want. So I think we got to teach our children that there are other people in the world, there are other people's feelings, and to respect that.
Yeah, and maybe that respect will spread. Well, thanks so much. I think you're spreading a wonderful message. PAVE's website is full of tips and resources related to bullying, and if you'd like to check it out, head on over to roadshow.com, where we'll post a link to that site.